Hello guys, Emmanuel here. In this video, we're going to learn how to use custom workflows with the Substance plugin for Blender. This video will be a bit more technical than the previous ones, since the custom workflows are based on JSON files at the moment. Right now, I'm working on an easier and more user-friendly way to use them, but I wanted to release this first iteration. That way, I can give access to the feature to everyone as soon as possible. So let's get started. To use any kind of workflow with the plugin, you need to have a preset file. Actually, included in the plugin, there are already two presets, representing a standard PBR metal roughness workflow, one for cycles and Eevee, and one for Octane. Every time you open Blender, the Substance plugin will read all these files in the presets folder, and will use them to establish the rules of each workflow. So to add a new preset, all we need to do is to create a new JSON file, and then open Blender. The JSON files are text-based, so they can be created with any text editor. I don't want to make this video too long, so I won't explain in detail how JSON files work, since there are already many tutorials about that subject. Still, if you have any issues creating them, don't hesitate to contact me via Discord, the link is in the description. Let's start with a simple version of a preset file. As you can see here, it has four major sections: maps, nodes, properties, and connections. The first one is maps. This section will define which outputs of a substance are enabled by default, and will be considered while creating the shader network. For example, if we create base color, the base color output will be enabled when we select the custom preset. Let's write normal. And save the file. Now let's reselect the preset inside the plugin. As you can see now, normal is also enabled. If we remove it and save again, only base color will be enabled. This gives us the ability to use any output map of any substance. For example, if we have a substance file like this one that has an output called Hello World, and we write Hello World in the JSON, that output will be recognized and enabled every time we select the custom preset. Let's try it out. And it works. The next section is called Nodes. And this one is a list of all the nodes that we want to add to the shader network. Each item in this list must contain a unique identifier. For example, here is 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then the type of the node. Here, shader node text chord, node mapping, text image, etc. And finally, a location, which will help organize the shader network in the editor. There is also an optional property for the name, like TX base color, material, and output, that will be set as the name of the node if it exists. And if you're creating an input image, like we are doing it here with the base color output, you also need to set a property called output that must match with the map you're going to use. This list structure gives us full control of the nodes that will be part of the shader network, and thanks to that, we can easily use custom Blender nodes if we want to. As a quick tip, if you want to find the name of a node, you can just go to the scripting tab, add the node, and you'll be able to find it here. The next section of the JSON is called properties. Here, you can add all the values of each node that you want to set. Each element of the list needs to contain the ID of the node you want to modify, the type of property, for example, image, string, float, the name of the property, and the value you want to assign. There are some special properties like the tiling type that doesn't require more information, and the image type that needs an extra definition of the color space you want to use, as well as a value defined as material underscore and the map you want to assign. The rest follow the ID, type, property, and value structure, as we can see here. As with the name of the nodes, you can go to the scripting tab and get the name of each property by changing its values, as you can see here. And the last section is called connections. This list will include all the connections of the shader network, and each element of the list needs a from property with the ID of the source node, then a to property with the ID of the destiny node, and a number indicating which output and input channels will be used for each connection respectively. Don't forget that the channel numbers start with 0 and not 1. Let's see the results of this preset inside Blender. That way, it will be easier to understand all these concepts. First, we can see that when we select the custom preset, The Hello World map is the only one enabled by default, since that is the only map that we have defined in the JSON. Then we have five nodes: a texture coordinate, a mapping node, an image texture, a principled shader, and an output. Then we can see that in the scale x and y of the mapping node, the value is 2, as defined by the tiling property. Next, we can see that the texture node has the Hello World image assigned, and the color space is sRGB. And finally, we can see that the distribution of the principled shader is GGX, as we defined in the file. In regard to connections, we can see that the texture coordinate 0 is connected to the mapping 1. From the output 2, remember the connections start counting at 0, to the output 0. The mapping 1 is connected to the texture image 2, the texture image 2 to the principled shader 3, and the shader 3 to the material output 4. And that is all. Pretty straightforward. Let's try adding some nodes, just to ensure that we understand the concepts. Let's add, for example, a Voronoi, and multiply it by the Hello World texture, then connect that to the base color of the shader. We start by adding the Voronoi node, then we add a Mix RGB node. Now we change the scale property of the Voronoi, which is called Inputs to Default Value. Then we change the Mix RGB blend type to Multiply. And finally, we make the connections. We go from Voronoi 5 to MixRGB 6, using the output 1 for the Voronoi and the input 1 from the MixRGB. Then we go from the texture 2 to the MixRGB 6, using the output 0 from the texture to the input 2 of the MixRGB. And finally, we connect the MixRGB to the principled shader 4, using the output 0 of the MixRGB and the input 0 of the shader. Let's click Create Material. And as we can see in the result, the Hello World output of the substance is multiplying the Voronoi, and the result is connected to the base color of the principled shader. As I said, this is a bit technical, and while straightforward, it can be difficult to grasp at the beginning. So if you have any doubts, contact me via Discord and I'll be happy to help you out. Also, I'm working on a more user-friendly approach that will be included in a future release. Well, that's all for now. Hope you like this release.
Good luck!